Hi guys, welcome to this week's Mad Skills Masterclass. I painted this board last week at a Margaret River Pro surfing event, and I thought this would be a good opportunity to show you guys how to clear coat surfboards. So you need to clear coat your surfboard because that's going to protect the artwork against scratches, sand abrasion, and it will also help protect it against UV rays from the sun, which is going to fade your artwork over time. Before we start, I just have to warn you that clear coating can be one of the most temperamental and heartbreaking steps in the whole artistic process. So if you do it wrong, you're going to end up with cracking, peeling, orange peel, and also blooming. So it's really important that you take your time and you get it right. If the paint and the clear coat have a really bad reaction, the only thing that you can do about it is basically sand the whole board back off and start again from the beginning. And really, you don't want to do that. There are two big issues in regards to clear coating. The first problem is normally a reaction between the paint and the clear coat that you're using, and this may look like cracks or blisters, or in worst cases the paint may actually start to peel off. To combat this, I always try to use the same brand of paint and clear coat together because I know they've been developed to work together. I'd advise you to test out your paints and your clear coat on a scrap piece of plastic, or maybe even an old broken board if you have one, just to double check they're going to work together before you spray the clear coat on top. The second problem is a big one, and that is weather. So clear coats are very sensitive to the temperatures and the humidity that you're spraying them on in. So before you start, check your weather report. If it's too hot, too cold, or too humid, you may get blooming, which is kind of an opaque, milky film in the clear coat, and you really don't want to get that. Step one, you've got to clean your board. So set yourself up in a well-ventilated area that's out of direct sunlight and also dust-free, if at all possible. You're going to need to get rid of any dust or anything else that's on the board because that will get caught up in and stick in your clear coat. So to do that, I'd advise using a soft, lint-free cloth. First thing you're going to need to do is you're going to need to take a can and you're going to need to give it a really good shake. So you can hear the mixing ball, and you need to shake it for at least a minute. And what that's going to do is combine all the solvents together inside the can so you get a nice clear spray. Hold the can about half a can length away from the board, and you want to apply it in long side-to-side strokes so that you're overlapping about 50% so there's no stripes. Make sure you keep the can moving the whole time. Don't stop in any one spot. You don't want to get too much clear coat on the board in one go because that can lead to cracking. You want to leave the board to dry for about 10 minutes. I'd advise you to read your instructions on your can because they all have different drying times. The one I'm using is 10 minutes. I'm going to apply a second coat, but this time I'm applying it in the opposite direction, which will make sure that there's no gaps in the clear coat. Leave it to dry again for the 10 minutes or however long you're going to leave it. And I'd recommend doing one more coat, maybe two, because you really want to have it nice and sealed on there. I'd also recommend leaving it overnight before you take it out for a surf, just to let the clear coat cure. Thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please like it or share it, or subscribe to Fieldey TV. If you've done any of these tutorials and you've got photos on Instagram, please tag them, Mad Skills Masterclass, and that way I can come and have a look.